Namaste, good morning. Thank you so much for joining this about an hour and 20 minute practice. Please practice according to your conditions and your abilities. Respect your limitations. Remember, the practice is an offering. So imagine, if you imagine that all beings are experiencing this through you, this may encourage you to practice in a way that is mindful, that is conscious, and that doesn't bring you to a place of pain and suffering, because that is what is transmitted to all other beings. So let's keep that in mind as we practice today. So on that note, let's begin. Close the eyes, bring the attention within. Begin with the sound of Om three times to attract divine attention. Imagine becoming one with all beings everywhere. Fix your mind on God alone. Rest your thoughts in God alone. And in God you will live hereafter. Of this there is no doubt. May all beings everywhere be happy and free from suffering, and enjoy this practice of our senses. May the Lord bestow upon us the fruits of knowledge, and may we always have a strong desire for the knowledge that liberates us from pain and suffering. And may we cherish no ill feelings against each other, only ever peace, love, joy, and compassion. Om Shanti, 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 peace, peace, peace. To make this practice even better than meditation, even more powerful and even more significant, that's all the fruits. Imagine this as your divine obligation to all beings everywhere. Do it because it must be done. So now let's do the mantra for purification, to purify the space, the grounds, and all the psychic channels within. If you know it, do it with volume and conviction so it can be heard by all the subtle bodies within and all around. If you don't know it, just pretend you're chanting for the voice of the Guru. You derive all the benefits of though you're chanting it perfectly. Om Pavitra Ha Pavitra Vasa Vashtanga Topi Vaya Ha Smari Pandrika Kshamsa Vaya Pihantra Ha Schihi. So let's start off with spiritual breathing in order to connect, establish a deeper connection with the divine essence as within, who resides in the spiritual heart in the center of the chest and the right side of the physical heart. The arms come up, palms that we turn up. So inhale from the fingertips down through the arms, bringing the best of the best. Feel as though you're coming right to the spiritual heart. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold everything in the heart, bring the attention, and hold the breath at the spiritual heart. 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale out through the fingertips. 2, 3, 4. It's just a breath leaves. Everything else that you pulled in stays within. 6, 7, 8. Inhale again, bring in everything you need down through the arms into the spiritual heart, direct path to God who resides there. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, holding the breath and the attention at the heart. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale up through the fingertips. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Last time, imagine there's a big magnet in the center of the chest, attracting everything you need. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep it all in the heart. Hold it as an offering to God who resides there. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale out through the fingertips. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bring your arms down now. So let's now do alternate nostril breathing, rhythmic style. The count is 3, 12, 6. 3 on the inhale, 12 on the breath retention, 6 on the exhale. Inhaling through the active nostril, which I'll explain in a moment. Hold the breath. As you hold the breath, engage the throat lock and a root lock. So for the throat lock, as you inhale, you want to bring the chest up high, so that when you bring your chin down on the chest, the back stays relatively straight. You don't want to hunch the back. The tip of the tongue to the roof of the mouth behind the teeth will seal off the lock completely. For the root lock, contract the buttocks, push the belly button into the front of the spine. So you imagine that you feel as though you're lifting the whole pelvic floor up towards your navel. That is the root lock. The attention is at the space between the eyebrows and the breath retention, and you're playing both sides of the nose. For the exhale, you're breathing out through the left active side, then reverse the inhale through the left active side, close both sides of the nose, both nostrils. Exhale out through the active side. Begin and end on the active side. For the hands, the left hand in Yana Mudra, the mudra consciousness stays all the time on your left side somewhere. Close to the knee or closer to the hip, it's your choice. And for the other hand, Vishnu Mudra, second, third fingers fold down toward the palms. This is the Vishnu Mudra. Once you turn a palm towards you, it's no longer Vishnu Mudra. Thumb for the right nostril, right ring finger for the left. For the active nostril, let's find it now. Close off the right side of the thumb. Send a few puffs of air rapidly through the left side. And then repeat on the other side. So close off the left side with the right ring finger. Breathe in a few times, breathe in and out. Whichever side feels more open is your active side. If you can't tell the difference, just use your left side as your active side. So, my left side appears to be the active side, usually changes every 2 hours. So, I will demonstrate with the left side as the active nostril, So here we're just trying to bring the state to the mind in the state of calmness. The more calm the mind is, and the less restless it is, the less prone it is to turning up desires that could lead to attachments, which leads to suffering. So we try to keep the mind nice and calm and free of that action, free of that restlessness. When you do this long enough, you start to really feel, it generates lots of prana. And it brings the state into a state, the mind into a state that's conducive to meditation. So do a few rounds just to get the technique. When you're doing it at home, try it for at least 12 cycles, and after a while, you can build. And then the mind is ready for meditation. So sit up tall and straight. Breathe out completely. Close off the last active side, inhale for the active. 3, hold the breath, apply the throat to the root lock. 4, the attention of the space between the eyebrows. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Exhale up through the last active side. 2, 3, be completely empty by the 6 count. 5, 6. Inhale again. 4, 3 counts through the last active side. 3, hold the breath, chin on the chest. Everything stops, all the attention of the space between the eyebrows. Through the active side. 2, 3. Push all the air out of the lungs. 5, 6. Inhale through the active. Hold the breath. We're starting cycle 2. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Exhale up through the last active side. Remember to release the locks on the exhale. 6, inhale through the left active side, fill up again, raise the chest, chin on the chest, third eye attention, everything stops, all the mind activity, the body moves, and emotion disorder flows. up through the left active side. 4, 5, 6. Inhale, feel less active. Hold for 12. Try to keep the attention to the space in your eyebrows. Up through the active side. Inhale. Hold. If your mind starts to wander, be unconcerned, unjudging. Just try to bring your attention back to space in your eyebrows. Continue. Exhale out through the less active side, remaining the witness, unaffected, unobserved, unjudging. Inhale through the less active. Hold. Exhale out through the active side. Last round. Hold. Exhale out through the less active. Inhale through the less active. Hold. Keep on applying the locks, do the breath retention, the throat tip and root lock and the root lock. Exhale out through the active side. The right hand comes down on the right knee. Sit tall and straight again. Take a moment to observe the state of the body, the mind, and emotions. Have no expectation as to what you should or should not observe. Have no attachment to any results. Now bring the attention to the space to me, to the center of the chest and right side of this card again, the spiritual heart, the residing place of God. Remain established in God, whose nature is divine love, compassion, and infinite wisdom, and recognize that you are of that same nature, and that God is equally present in all forms, all beings. Now through the asana practice, we will celebrate the magnificence of God and how God manifests in this universe through all the different forms. Revere and love them all. So on that note, let's begin the practice. So we're going to stand now. We're going to start off with some exercises first in order to promote the release of impurities through just generating some heat and just allowing all those impurities just leave through the sweat and through the heat. So, oops, much better. Okay, so now for this first one, we're starting off with the organs. As we're doing this, we're pumping the belly button in at a very fast rate. Try for at least 50 times as you hold the breath out. And then as you're doing this, you're shaking, feeling all the organs being shaken. Imagine all the impurities tumbling out of the body, out of the organs. So take a deep breath in. Exhale, bend down, hands on the knees, stay empty, and start to pump the belly button in as fast as you can. Push the belly button in front of the spine to pull the breath out. That you're trying to push the heart between your shoulder blades, the belly button right through the lower back. And release, coming back up. Breathe in. Breathe out. Relax. We'll do it one more time. Inhale and exhale. Empty out completely. And again, relax the belly muscles so you can pop the belly button out easily. Push blood by distance from the spine again, hollow up the area underneath the rib basket, make it very thin. And release, coming back up. Breathe in. And breathe out. Good. And now continue the exercise. I apologize, the light's not very good here, so hopefully you can still see. I'm in a different space here, and the lighting is a little bit not so good, but we'll try it, okay? So, standing with your feet about 10 inches apart, hands on the hips, start with the head circles, roll the head all the way around the neck. Try to get the ears to shoulders, the chin to the chest, the back of the head to the top of the back. And go in the opposite sense now. Try to move the joints each and every day to keep the body in a state of radiant health. And now inhale, raise your arms up. Exhale down. Continue. Do the movements with energy, the breathing with vigor. Inhale, arms up, spread the fingers. Exhale, pull your hands down. Form fists as the hands come down. Inhale, straight out in front. Exhale, snap the hands back to the front of the shoulders. Now, throw the arms back and forth. Try to get the arms behind the ears. Start up now and inhale. Exhale, the arms come down to the right, down as you turn to the right. As you turn to the left, the arms come back up. Arms come up again, turn to the left this time. As the arms come down, as you turn to the right, the arms come back up. So the arms should be spinning in opposite directions. Back up, from here, arms down. So next one, arms across the chest and inhale, exhale, throw the arms back. Alternate across each time your arms come across the chest. Next one, arms up over the head, inhale. Exhale, toss the body down. Allow the belly to hit the thighs. Come back up. Next one, arms come up over the head. Inhale. Exhale, drop down into squat. If you can't go down all the way, just come down as far as you can. Be mindful of your knees. This one, arms come across the front of the chest. Hold the opposite arms. Open up your feet a little bit more. Your feet can be about the width of the mat. You're going to go this from side to side. So you can do Kapalabhati as you're doing this. Exhale as you turn all the way to one side. The inhale happens and then as passively as you come back to the center. Look all the way around you. Don't head all the way back. Thank you.
and come back to the center. Next one. Arms up. So this one again has a squat. So four movements. Inhale, circle the arms up. Exhale, down. Inhale, jump up. Exhale, down. You don't have to jump if it's too hard on your ankles or your joints. You can just lift your heels. But if you can, jump. Pretend you're a jack in the box being pushed back down and then spring me out of the box. Arms in front of the body, head to the shoulders, inhale, circle around to the front, exhale, pull and then punch right back out. Feel as though the arms were spring-loaded. Next one, the same movement, but the arms are down, going a full circle and a quarter this time. Inhale, circle to the front, exhale, pull down and drop your arms down immediately. A little bit more, going from side to side, left arm up, inhale, bend to the right on the exhale, right arm up, inhale, exhale, bend to the left. Next one is the same movement, but the breathing's a little bit different. Left arm up, inhale. Hold the breath, bend to the right. Exhale, come back up. Right arm up, inhale. Hold the breath, go to the left. Come back. I like to turn the foot a little bit so the toes are pointing in the opposite direction where I'm leaning. Put it on your foot. Try not to make folds in the other side of the body. Open up the heart in every sense, physically, spiritually, emotionally. We're moving away, that doesn't incur pain or suffering or anxiety. Because all beings will feel that for you. All movement's graceful. Moving away that doesn't cause agitation of the mind, restlessness of the mind. Love the absence of activities, and that's in the physical, mental, and mental sense also, an emotional sense. Try to keep the mind always even, unchanged. Do one more repetition on each side. Stretch the whole length of the body from the foot all the way to the fingertips. And now the other way. Extend the inhale, hold the breath, go even further. And then break the pose. So let's come down onto the hands and knees.
the cat-cow. Wisdom, knee to shoulders, knees butt hip width apart. Inhale, arch the back. Exhale, round the back. Inhale. Stretch the belly skin. Exhale, stretch the back skin. Inhale. Telescope the back shoulders, the trunk out of the hips. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, move your way that doesn't make any folding at the lower back or the back of the neck. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, keep the chest open. Imagine you're trying to push the heart rate between the shoulder blades and the belly button to your lower back. Inhale. Exhale. Still allow the breath to pass even when the chin comes to the chest. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Oh my gosh. Scan. Exhale. Stretch it back to your neck. Last time. Inhale. And exhale. Back to neutral back. This one is for the hips. Raise your right leg up on the inhale. Swing it out to the right on the exhale. So throw the leg up there. And then out to the side. Try to keep the foot forward past the shoulder. If you need to, you can keep your knee bent. Modify the movement as you need to. Inhale, swing it up to the left. Try to get your foot all the way above your head. Or a cushion underneath your body with the edge of the edge at the top of the legs. This is so the hips don't grind into the ground. So you're lying on your stomach, this is for your upper back. Squeeze the palms together if you can as you come up. If it's too much for your shoulders, keep your hands apart. Anchor down to the tops of the legs, your thighs, and the tops of the feet. Inhale, come up. Exhale down. Up. Down. Inhale, exhale, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. This time we're going to hold it. Inhale, up. You're trying to get them right over the feet. And down. Relax. Breathe in. Breathe out. All 15. Next one. The arms are out in front. So you have a couple of options here, or three options. Raise the legs and arms at the same time. And then come back down. Or raise the opposite arm to opposite leg. Just alternate between the two. Engage your upper back muscles again, engage your buttocks. If you have more strength, you can pull the legs up, and as the hips and the chest are coming down, just throw the upper body. So take this. Continue with the option break. Not to use your hands too much, they'll stop the moment. The body moving. And then make the pose.
forehead on the hands, breathe in. And breathe out. Relax. So now next. Four movements for this one. Start with your seat behind heels in child's pose. Inhale, come up, high cat. Exhale, cobra, hips to your hands, chest forward, shoulders back. Inhale, come back into high cat. Exhale, all the way back, child's pose. Inhale, mounting. Exhale, flex in the spine. Back to rounding, flattening and lengthening. Inhale, up. Moving away again, that doesn't create any sharp bends in the at either back side of the spine, either ending spine and back. Up. And forward, imagine you can see right through the skin of the spine moving and back. Try to make it so that the spine always stays like a smooth curve, unbroken, uninterrupted. And back up. And back. Allow the prana to flow freely. Inhale. Exhale, toss the leg out of the shoulders. Inhale, back up. Exhale, all back. Up. Forward. Back up. And all the way back. Inhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Powerful movements yet with them with the utmost grace. Up and back. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. You can imagine your wave emerging from the ocean. Reaching its full height and start to crest and then disappear back into the water. And forward. Up. And back. Inhale. One more, inhale, and forward, push your shoulders back, chest forward, inhale, and back, stay in child's pose for a moment, breathe in, and breathe out, relax, let go of all fatigue, let go of all efforts. Next one, we're going to make our way into cobra on the inhale. So there's a couple of different entries. You can either pull yourself forward on the inhale, drag the body forward to the arms, hold the palms, hold the breath. Make sure you don't lose your neck. Telescope your neck out of the shoulders. And back on the exhale. If that's a challenging entry for you, you can just come into baby plank. Telescope over the wrist. Hips drop to your hands, chest forward, and the head goes back. And back. So continue now with the entry of the foot. Pull the elbows towards the side of the body, turn the fingers out, this helps you with your gliding. And back, exhale. Inhale, glide, pull up the floor, much time to drag the floor towards you. Hold the breath, hold the pose. And back, exhale. Inhale. Maybe you could snake creep into the grass. Uncoiling majestically. Hold the breath, hold the pose. And back. If you see yourself in the form, imagine having a balanced range of motion of the circuits. Forward and up. Hold the breath, hold the pose. And back. Try to embody all the qualities of that. What you're representing, be fierce and fearless, wise and powerful. And back, exhale. Glide again. Brush
nose to ground. Come all the way up. The head goes back. Try to get the back of the head over the top of the seat. And back, exhale. So this one, moving a few more joints at the same time. Come forward. Rajabhujangasana, King Cobra. Pull. Come onto your fingertips. Lift the palms. Bring the feet up towards the head. With the toes. And back. Don't worry if you can't touch the back of the head. Just keep visualizing it. Keep visualizing the form. The body will come closer and closer to realizing it. And back, exhale. Through constant practice, anger, determination, and most important, observance of the ethical rules, anything is possible. You'll have the chance to experience everything as you move further and further down the path of yoga. Back, exhale. Glide. Imagine you're squeezing socks behind your knees. You have to bring your hips right behind your hands. The hands are close to the hips. Get as much height as you can. And then the feet might come closer to the head. Come back. Come forward. Don't worry about the results. Let go of all expectations. Let go of all attachment to the results. Back, exhale. And come forward again. Come up high, hold the breath, hold the pose. And back. So rest now, breathe in, breathe out. So now we're going to come forward onto the belly again, slip onto your back. Tucks here, arms and legs extend fully on the inhale, exhale, come into a tuck. Squeeze the knees to the shoulders, the shoulders to the knees, forehead between your head and your knees. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, pull up. Don't worry if you can't take your forehead to your knees or your hands. Just do your best. Inhale. Exhale, just press the thighs into the abdomen. Inhale. Again, powerful movements. Inhale, stretch. Exhale. Inhale, remember, now things are best of your best. So put some effort into it. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Spread the fingers and the toes. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale this time. And exhale. Next one, inhale. Hold the breath as you come into tuck. Hold the position. Everything stops. Again, all the mind activity, the body movements, and the emotions are frozen. Release, exhale. Inhale, stretch. Hold the breath and tuck. Use your elbows to squeeze against the other sides of the knees. Bring one foot in front of the other. Can't reach your forehead, your hands easily. And release it. Even if your hand, your forehead doesn't come back to the hands, don't worry about it. Just do your best. Concentrate on the space between your eyebrows, regardless of where you're at. Exhale. Inhale, elongate. Hold the breath and tuck. Break the pulse. Inhale, stretch. Hold. Make yourself open the tight, tight paw. Release, exhale. Inhale, extend. Hold the back and tuck. Release, exhale. Two more. Inhale, stretch. Push out through the heels. Hold the breath. Come into the tight paw. Release, one more, inhale, stretch, and hold the breath, tuck. Break the pose, breathe in,
breathe out, just allow all the tension to drop out of the body. Next one, rolling back and forth. Just massage the spine a little bit. So depending on your abilities, you either just come into tuck and roll and keep the form of a tuck. If you have more strength, you can start with your arms and legs extend. Try not to bend your legs or your arms. Go all the way back with your feet behind your head in halasana. Bring the feet all the way down. Once the heels are down, come all the way up to seated and pull your body over your legs. So do the variation that's reflecting your ability. Do your best. Go to edge your potential every time. So you keep on moving forward. Always moving the edge a little bit further each time. No jerky movements. No crash in the kicks of the back with the legs on the ground. Do one more. Full one. Next time you roll back, make way to stand. So the legs are coming down. Bend your knees. Plant your feet. And come all the way up to standing. Getting ready for Surya Namaskar. So, sweep the front of the mat. Okay, so just so now I'll come to the front of the mat. Remember to keep on offering up the poses. Imagine together moving like a school of fish. Stay in a collective mind of offering. Raise your arms up, arch back. Fold the body down, chest on the thighs, head down. Right foot back, lower down the knee, drop down to the seat. Come into the high plank. Knees down, feet, chest forward, and come right through into upward facing dog. Push out your hands, lift the knees away from the ground. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana, lift the feet, allow the head to come down. Try to be flexible, try to straighten the forehead to the ground. Then a right foot steps forward to the hands. If that's a difficult transition, lower the back knee down first. Use your right hand to glide the foot forward if you need. Feet together, chest on the thighs again, head down. Come right up and back, engage the buttocks. And the upper back muscles to support your movement, hands for the heart. Go up and back. Don't worry about the breath. Move by the breath and follow and do a little more power and ease to the movements. Into the plank. Ashtanga Namaskar, knees, chest, forehead down. Come right through. Again, push into your hands, charge your legs, lift the hips and knees away from the ground, upward facing dog. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana, soften the lying back. Left foot steps towards the hands, feet together, head down. Come right to stand, reach up and back. Come back home. Be the witness, watching body moving all by itself. Come forward and down, Uttanasana, right foot back, into the plank. If that makes sense, keep up or you miss it all. Knees, chest, forward, head down, right into upward facing dog. If you need to modify, keep your hips on the ground. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. The right foot forward, feet together. Come right up and back. And then Pranamasana, always coming back to source of divine love. Reach up and back. Inject every moment with love and devotion. Left foot leads this time into lunge, into the high plank. Down we go. Swing right through to upward facing dog. Push into your hands. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Left foot steps forward. Feet together. Chest on the thigh. Try to get your seat in line. The heels if you can. The attaching body from the legs. Come all the way up. And back home, hands to the heart. Reach up and back. Don't worry about the breath. Just move the body. The breath will follow. This time, bend your knees. Hands behind the back. Pull hands all the way up over your shoulders. Try to get your legs straight. Right foot back. Back and down. Kapyasana.
raise arms up, pull the arms all the way back behind the ears, stretch, legs trying to make their way over the toes. Come back into high plank. Do the same entry, or you can do chaturanga if you like. Lower down and one leg from heels to the top of the head, and come right into upward facing dog, dropping your legs to the ground. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Right leg up, three-legged dog. Step the foot between the hands, flat knee down. Again, Kapyasana, reach arms up, arch the back. Trying to, if your arms are up here, it doesn't really do much for your shoulders. Reach up, drop your shoulders, and pull them back behind the ears or beside the ears. Come forward, swing your hands behind the back without touching from the ground if possible. Left foot comes beside the right, Uttanasana. Come right up to standing. Salute and bring it home, hands to the heart. Go up and back. And down, belly on your thighs. Push your body into your legs, try to get your legs straighter, seat, and lift your heels eventually. And then the left foot goes back. Kapyasana. Reach up, circle your arms all the way back. Good. Stretch, drop your shoulders from the toes to the fingertips, one this nice, smooth curve, no breaks along the way. No interruptions in the prana flow. And break the pose, come back down into high plank. Entry of your choice into upward facing dog. Again, you can do chaturanga if you like. Press up the heels, top of the head, and push into your hands. Right to upward facing dog. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Left leg up, Ekapada, Adho Mukha Svanasana, and then the foot between the hands. Try not to land the foot heavily, softly. Hands to the heart. Move like you move your energy, like you see yourself moving the dreams with grace, with fluidity, with silence. Reach back, stretch, and then break the pose. So you have to kind of back, hold the breath, so you can bring the right foot forward without a big loud noise, with control, always. Go up and back. And then bring it back in line. Bear your mind deep in the heart, watch going with even more power, grace, and ease. Bend your knees, belly on your thighs, hands all the way up off your back, forehead to your shins if your legs are perfectly straight. And then a right foot back. Kapyasana. Reach up and back, stretch the whole front of the body. And come right back into high plank. Another entry if you like, to consider bring your seat all the way back. And then come all the way through the dropping legs. You're going to have to push the elbows into the sides of the body. Press through the base of the toes, press through the base of the fingers. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Right leg up, three-legged dog. Step the foot between the hands. Reach up and back. Remember your abilities. Just go. Don't go to place of pain or suffering or anxiety. Swing your hands on the back. Feet together. Uttanasana. Come right up. Arch back, Pranamasana, and again, connect the movement seamlessly like you're doing a divine dance of devotion. Chest and thighs together, reach hands over your back, over your shoulders, left foot goes back. Kapyasana, stretch back, and come right back into high plank. Move between the forearms like a shapeshifter effortlessly, a seat back. The elbows inside by, turn the fingers out. If you're doing that entry into upward facing dog, roll over the toes. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Left leg up, three-legged dog, step the foot between the hands. Keep seeing yourself in the practice of trying to tame. And use your imaginations. See yourself in the forms. And then eventually when you find the form, just see if you can know. Merge the form, Uttanasana. Come right to standing, reach up and back. And come back home, hands to the heart. Good. Different variation this time, jump back. If you can't jump, just walk back. So no stopping between each one. Raise your arms up, swing your arms back behind the head, come forward and down. Bend your knees, hands to the ground, pushing your hands for the breath, jump right back into chaturanga, hovering just above the ground. Into upward facing dog, back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Immediately bring your feet forward, hopping or walking. Come right up to standing, reach up and back. Right into the next one. Up down, head towards the feet. Set your hands, jump to the left. nice soft jump, no big, again, no jarring movements. Downward facing dog, jump your feet forward, reach up and back. This is just to build some heat, hands to the ground, bend your elbows and go back. So let your body lands in the same even length you do on the top of the head. Jump forward, reach up and back, and come down one more time, hands to the ground. Bend your elbows, arms come to upward facing dog, and downward facing dog. Immediately feet forward to the hands, reach up and back, and then return home. Take pause here, the hands in front of the heart, Anjali Mudra. From the heart, inhale the love from the heart up to the crown. Hold the breath, imagine love going into all beings everywhere. Just like the sun, it shines down on everything equally. Exhale back down to the heart, remain established in divine, unconditional love for all beings. And release. So now let's continue synchronous. Okay, so now from here, let's start off with going to the back of the mat. Arms up over the head. If it's too much, I have your arms over the head. You can take your arms out to the side like an airplane. So from here, warrior three, step forward, left foot, bend your left knee, hinge at the hips. Raise your right leg up, straighten out the left leg. Straight line, send the foot, the top, toes all the way to the fingertips. Like a line on the table. Good. Now from here, we're going to come up. I'm going to turn forward so you can see. Take hold the heel from the inside, ballet pose. Try to have your toes and fingers in the same line. So it might look like a T, or more flexible. Bring the foot up higher, lean a little bit to your left. Flex the foot. Open up the gaze to the chest, the sky, like a dancer, magnificent and poised and graceful. Good. Now from here, back into warrior three if you can. Come forward, right up the room here. And from here, either out in the airplane or arms in front again. And then at your left knee, press into your left foot and come back up. Release. Try it on the other side now. Arms up over the head if you're doing the warrior three or out to the side. Right foot forward, hinge at the hips. Left leg lifts up as your body comes down. And then straighten up the right leg. Even line, level to the ground. Now press into your right foot, hold the breath, come up into ballet pose. Again, I'll turn this way. Take hold of the foot. From the inside, ballet pose. Try to have your arm and the leg at the same angle. Look up, off of the pose. Now from here, I have to turn again. Release the foot into warrior three or airplane again. Press into the right foot, hold your breath, come up, release, charge the body. Inhale, the best of best, right into the body, right up the spine to the crown. Exhale, send everywhere through the body. Everything, remember, meant to be shared. So now, dancer, Nata Vajrasana. Stand on your left foot, raise your right foot up. Take hold of the ankle from the outside, left arm up. If this is where you're at, you stay there. But if you can, bend your left knee, lean forward, push the foot away from your body. If you can, take your left hand back. You might want to bring your foot in closer to the seat first. Standing both palms, keep your foot in both hands, chest forward. Good. Now from here, bring your knee forward again. You can bring your left hand to the outside of the knee, right hand to the seat, look over your right shoulder, bring your right arm back. If you can, you can take your foot, slide your hand down to the edge of the foot, outside edge, and extend the leg forward. Push through the base of the toes. Good, one more transition. Take the knee back, take hold of the ankle again, bend your left knee. If you can, take your left hand to the ground. Otherwise, you're a repeat dancer. Pull the right leg all the way back. It should feel like a bow pose. Then release the foot out in asana. Extend your leg. And from here, break the pose. Bring the weight back down. Head heavy as you roll your way up. Go right to the other side. Right arm comes up. Left knee comes up. Tip over the foot. Again, do according to your abilities. You can stay here or bend your right knee a little bit to sink our way into your right foot and push the foot away. Once your foot is far away from the bar as possible, straighten out the right leg again. Dancer, Nakadasana. You can also bring your foot close to your seat. Take hold of the foot with both hands, the right hand to the foot as well, and push the foot away from the body again. Try to have your toes on the same line as the head. Bring the knee forward, slip your left hand to the back of the seat, right hand to the outside of the knee, push your lower back up and in, look to your left, or your left shoulder if you want, slide your foot down, your hand down to the foot, outer edge of the foot, extend the left leg, the left arm back. Good, pull the knee back in, change hands again to pull the ankle with your left hand. Bend your right knee, bring your fingertips to the ground, not too close to the foot, about 14 or 16 inches away. Pull your foot all the way up and back again, away from the seat. Make a bow pose, stretch the whole front of the body. Then release the leg, extend the leg, left arm goes up, fingers together, toes pointed to make it look pretty. And then bring the elbows. Bring your left foot back down, head heavy, roll your way up. Again, try to balance, bring the palms forward. Inhale, advance the chest right up into the, right up the spine to the crown. Exhale, send it everywhere. Good. Now, from here, we're going to move into some warrior poses. From here, standing in the little mat, facing on the long edge of the mat. Bring your fingertips in line with your elbows at the height of the shoulders. Jump or step your feet apart, turn to your left. Virabhadrasana. If you can, go a little bit deeper by bending the left knee a little bit more. Lowering the hip, try to get your knee over the toes. Look over the front hand, enter into the warrior consciousness. Strong, steady, determined, powerful. All the qualities are already within, you just have to turn them on. From here, turn forward, back knee down, hands together, Kali Mudra. The mudra that represents the embodiment, the Kali, the embodiment of fierceness and fearlessness and transformation. Lift the chest, push the lower back up and in. Again, try to get your arms behind your ears, not in front of the head. Pull all the way up, and then drop the shoulders, bring your arms back. Stretch the whole front of the body from the toes to the fingertips. Then from here, press into the front knee, come upright. Bring your left foot in a little bit so it's underneath the heels, underneath the knee, bend the toes under your back foot. The legs should look like a box. You can take your left foot up easily. It's in the right place. Padavrita Paschkanasana, right arm up, angle the toe towards the right, push the elbow away with your left hand, so you can dive down to the outside. Try to get the arm from the outside of the knee, your left hand pushes into your right, so don't stay here. You push down towards the ground, come behind your thumbs. And then keep turning, keep pushing the back of the arch shoulder against the outside of the knee, turn the face and chest up. If you have a bind, go ahead, push your hips back, if you have flexibility, use your left hand if you need to just tap on the back of the arm, the forearm, and the wrist. Left arm then goes over your back. Join your hands together underneath your belly. And can either stay here or lift the back knee up off the ground. Push the base of the toes. Keep pulling on the arm to get more rotation. It's like, it'll let you look like you're lying on your back almost. Break the pose. come with the hands inside, left foot, move the left foot out to the edge of the mat. Rock back and forth. Try to get your hips to sync with each pass. Push back one more time to the right foot, lower the knee. If your hips are low enough, fall onto your right forearm and your right hip, and then roll back to your left. Both sides, your hips equally down, equally close to the ground. Maybe even on the ground. When the hips are anchored, the rest of the body will follow. You try to get your back lower than the knee. Keep telescoping your head and chest forward out of the hips. If you're very flexible, your hips are already down, bring the belly and the chest and the chin down. Look like a lizard just sunning itself on the warm earth. Keep your gaze open like a lizard that doesn't blink. Merge with the form. Come back onto the hands. From here, bend the toes on the back foot. And then lift the back knee up, come back, tune your legs, and come all the way up. Go to the right, turn the right foot forward, virabhadrasana. Stay, pay attention to the form, make sure the back arm is not dropping down. Keep it level with the left, right arm, look over the front hand. And now from here, bring the back knee down, turn forward, flatten out the toes. Your seat is all the way forward towards front heel. Otherwise, you might have trouble balancing, and then you end up like this. So bring your seat all the way forward towards front heel, and pull your arms all the way back. Drop your shoulders down. Curve your back. Try to get your index fingers over the back toes. Give the shape of a crescent moon, radiate your light from within, just like the moon reflects the light of the sun. Lose yourself in the pause. And then pause, just whisper it, see if it's human to you. Stay in the pose for long enough. Now break the pose. From here, we're going to come back upright. Bring the right foot in, bend the toes under the back foot. Again, make sure that your head, your hip, and your knee are in the same line, your heel underneath the knee. And so you can do a little test, raise your right foot up. Good, then keep it in place, left arm up, angle the toe knee towards the left. Bring your arm all the way down, arm fairly outside the knee. Right hand pushes into your back. Sometimes it's just a little bit easier to push. And keep pushing downward. At the same time, the belly is coming up higher than the thigh. Roll the right shoulder back. Turn the face and chest up. Listen to the chest behind your thumbs. Do the bind if you like. And if you don't have a bind, you can just also lift the knee up off the ground. But if you want to try the bind, sometimes it's easier to knee up if you can keep your balance. You have more room underneath, so you're not obstructed by the vertical back leg, left arm goes underneath your leg, right arm goes over your back. Join your hands together and pull on your right arm. Try to get your chest rotated around. Break the pose, bring your hands back to the inside of the right foot. The right foot goes out to the edge of the mat. Rock back and forth. With constant practice, you also learn lots of tricks to come into the pose more efficiently, and then this allows you to go into the pose quickly so you can stay in the pose longer. Lower the knee down, flatten out the toes, fall onto your left forearm if your hips are low enough, and then roll back to the right. Otherwise, just stay in your hands and keep on sinking your hips down. Feel as though they're made of lead. And the more you lengthen, the more the body will approach the ground. Visualize a lizard just basking in the sun. Become that image. Now come back onto the hands. Step the right foot back beside your left. Vatsyasana, starting in plank. Move your left hand to the right a little bit. Turn to the right. Just turn on the feet. If your hips are starting to drop, you're dropping to the shoulder. Bring your left knee down in line with your hip. Do it from here, protect your joints. So So from here, you can come into some variations. You can maybe lift the right leg up. You can bring it behind, slide it in a little bit, alongside the left knee. While you push it up, make sure the inside edge of the foot down. Push it forward as well, up as high as possible, so that you have all the weight of your left hand and left foot, and then you can take the right foot up more easily. You can take your foot up, take the knee, more flexible, you can take the foot if you want. Again, according to your practice and your abilities. Break the pose, up back raise, you keep your arm fully extended, keep your hips up as you move back to high plank, and then go on the other hand. Turn to your left. Vasisthasana, your hands in the same line, from hand to hand, top of the head to the top of the to the toes, also straight line. And then after a while, you can go into other variations if you like, or modifications. Turn on your right foot. Make sure your toes are not pointed, or still not a 9 degree to the leg. You have to turn the foot so that the toes are roughly the same line as the rest of the leg, pushing all the way up. So you're trying to get your knee over your foot. Try not to bend the right leg. So you can take your left foot up off the ground. You can take hold of the knee. Maybe take hold of the foot. Push your hip all the way up. Break the pose. Come back into high plank. From here, jump your feet to the hands. Come into squat, turn toes out. Bring your arms between your legs. Push the outside of the arms against the inner thighs. And down, crow pose. I'm just gonna go back a little bit. Stop. Raise your hands down, lift the heels. Squeeze the insides of the thighs against the arms, the shoulders, and the knees together. Hold your breath so you can take your toes away from the ground. If you feel comfortable here, you can tip down, keep pressing your arms against the legs, and vice versa. The forehead comes on the ground. Come into teddy bear. Your seat comes up over your shoulders. If that's too much and then not comfortable entry for you, you can just stand, strap your heels, your knees on the ground, your hands beside your knees. Bring your forehead down from your knees and lift your seat. Lift your seat, knees up off the ground, walk your toes right behind your wrists. Rest just on the knees against your elbows. And then here, so you can pull your toes away from the ground. Even just 1 foot, dance from 1 foot to the other. Those who want to go into headstand, go ahead. Again, bring your legs all the way up for the traditional headstand, or split your legs to make it easier for you to balance. Your feet are close to the seat. Your knees are very bent. Flex your feet. Press to the base of the toes. More advanced, come onto your fingertips. Maybe lift one finger up at a time until you're just on the index finger. Maybe just the fingernail all the way almost on the head. Do according to your comfort level again and your abilities. From here, come back down. If you're in headstand, go back to teddy bear. Once you're in teddy bear, you can raise your head up off the ground. Flex your feet, tuck the tail under, hold the breath, press into the ground with your hands, lift your head up, and then bring your feet back down. Child's pose. Forehead on the ground, sit behind the heels, breathe in, breathe out. Let go of all fatigue again. Roll your way up, bring your legs out in front, lie on your back. So we're going into bridge pose here. Good. The feet are close to the seat, lift the seat. Bring your arms underneath the body, so from your belly cap ceiling, push your chest all the way up so the chest is close to your chin. If you feel like your knees are over your toes, push into the arms closer to the shoulders. The upper arms. Try to get your chest up even higher. Your chest should look like a wall. So you can stay here, or you can put your hands onto your back,
the fingers facing towards the backs and knees, bring the elbows in a little bit closer so the arms are all the way up to the body. Raise the left leg up, extend your leg up. If you want, you can go bring your right leg up as well. So bring your left foot a little bit further over your head, behind your head. Hold your breath, keep pressing your hands into your back, and bring your right foot up to meet. And from here, keep pushing into your back, push your hips forward, you can come into full shoulder stance. And do according to your abilities, otherwise you stay in bridge, or you can bring one, just keep your left leg up. And if you're just doing the one leg up, switch sides now. Your left foot comes down, your right knee comes up into your chest, extend the right leg up. If you're in shoulder stand, you stay there. If you're in bridge pose, you can stay there as well. Keep the mind ever quiet. Just become one with the form. And more importantly, one with God who's in all forms. And from here, if you're in full shoulder stand, bring one leg over behind your head. Come down one foot at a time. Try not to land your feet heavily. Come down. And from here, you can either stay in bridge, or those you want, or the Dandasana, put your fingertips behind your head, press into your fingertips, and then slide your head back a little bit, closer to your feet, turn your hands around so your fingers are now facing a little bit outwards and up towards your heels. Lift the head up off the ground. This pose, it demands lots of stamina, angry determination. Stretch the whole front of the body, bring your chest forward in front of the arms, if you like. Get your arms and legs straighter. And then come back down. From here, rest for a moment. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, relax. Scooch, lift the right side of the seat, slip your right hand underneath, your palms are down, and your legs. Do the same thing with the other leg. So roll your arms underneath your body again, your hands moving a little bit closer towards the heels. Fingers, palms down. Lift your back up off the ground, push into your chest up as high as you can, move the elbows a little bit closer together behind your back, and then bring the top head to the ground, fish pose. And keep like this, or raise your legs 12 inches off the mat, and now breathe very fast through the nose if you're slipping off. Down, bring your legs down, take a deep breath in, exhale, imagine you're fainting. Now from here, press into your arms, bring your feet up and all the way back, again behind your head. You have the option just roll into both without holding your legs, or you can hold the back knees, or even the toes. Hold your breath, see if you can come up without bending your legs if you're holding your toes. Not important if it doesn't happen. Push your belly forward towards your thighs, and from here, you can either open up your legs a little bit, hold your two fingers, your thumb around the big toes, and stay with your legs apart, or if you're more flexible, cross your arms behind your legs, and bring your shins all the way up close to your face. Try to get your chest high and the knees. It's on your seat. You need to bend your legs. You can, so you can hold. You can do this like this. Okay, so just do according to your abilities again. Now, release the legs. Boat pose, Navasana. So your legs straight or bent, and then breathe very fast. Your feet down on the ground, toes pointed out, fingers pointing out. Push your hips all the way up, bench pose. Try not to sag the hips. Push your hips up so there's a thin line as the shoulders and the knees, your chest high and the shoulders. Head goes back. Again, make the belly jump. Breathe very fast. The nose.
lower the seat down. Good. So from here, keep your knees bent, the right hand behind the back, left arm up, reach up, go to the right. Push your arm against the outside of the right thigh. Inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, turn to the right, look over your right shoulder. Center, left hand behind the back, right arm up, reach up, go to the left. Use the right arm to pull the knees beyond the right edge of the body. Try not to lean back, this does nothing. Your hand right against the back, your back straight. Turn to look over your left shoulder. Break the pose, one more. If this is an option, if you like, lift your seat. This one's gonna see a little bit more. Lift the heels, reach your arm up, and then go down. Dive down to the left arm up. On the outside of the right thigh, move your elbow a little bit closer in so that it's right close to your seat, beside your right hand, and push the right elbow into the side of the body. Now come forward with your chest, tip forward so you can get your feet up off the ground. Your legs are perched on your left arm, outside left arm, and then you can bring your forehead, your side of the right head down if you like. If you know the variations, go ahead. You can extend your legs. Can you bring your left leg up and back? Kundinasana. Come back down. Try it on the other side now. If you can't go into the pose, you just stay in the twist. Your right arm can just stay on the outside of the leg. You lift your seat up, your heels, you have more room to open up and to come down a little bit further. Your elbow get close to your hip, your right hand in line to your left, and dig the left elbow right at the top of the hip. Lean forward, reach forward to the head, and your hips are in the same level. And you can, again, extend your legs if you like, bring your right leg back, even take your left side of the head to the ground, your left temple. Break the pose, lie on the back, Shavasana. Feet are open, falling outwards, the hands about 12 inches away from the body, palms facing up. Inhale, imagine you're attracting all the tension to the center of the body. Exhale, just instantly release it all, drop it right out of the body. Feel completely relaxed. Surrender completely to relaxation. And make yourself, just make your body in a state that is more receptive to receiving all the fruits of the practice. Let go of all mental barriers as well. Be grateful for all that you're receiving now. And it comes in fuller force as a result of you offering up the practice and the efforts. Grateful for all that coming in, it's coming from all beings around you doing the same thing. We share with each other psychically through the practice. And give back now. So everything that you're receiving, direct it all now to the spiritual heart where God resides, that common thread that binds us all together. Through God, who is equally present in all forms, you transmit everything to all beings. Carry this intention into your day-to-day lives. It doesn't stop when you leave the mat. Continue to exercise compassion and love to all beings. Reflect it in your actions. actions, your words, and your thoughts. Through constant adherence to ahimsa, to the ethical rules, becomes a natural habit. You don't even have to think about it. To keep on bringing this out into your day-to-day lives now in all your directions. Prepare to sit. Come back in a way that is mindful, that is quiet, that is reverent. Close with Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Instill the peace within, send out to all beings everywhere. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Give yourself into the grace of God, all is within. Namaste, thank you so much for joining. If you'd like to do more shavasana now to further allow, to allow the benefits to further integrate, go ahead. Otherwise, have a wonderful day and hope to see you soon. Much love. Namaste.